More often than not, while the rest of your court is sound asleep, you find yourself staring at the ceiling. You are getting older each day, closer to leaving this plane of existence. It is folly to fear such things, of course, yet you cannot keep these feelings at bay. Didn't you used to dream the grander things, of grander things? What about your carving your own path? What happened to your ambitions?
Oh, yeah.
You sit up straight in your bed. This is ridiculous. You are the ruler. You have people to serve you. Your any whim. Perhaps your counselors have ideas. If nothing else, it might ease your trouble sleeping. Well, let's see. You summon your a secret meeting. And thank you for the follow. Our newest member. Okay, let's see. Meeting of the minds. Your council convenes and the faces of your advisors speak of confusion. Why are we here, my lord? It comes with a hint of concern. You sit down and the suspense is almost tangible. As you leave the question hanging in the air, finally you speak and without disclosing much of your current nightly restlessness, you convey the message eloquently enough. I want to discuss the concept of life and death. And I want to look into everlasting life. Be not slowly. So, what do you think? The spirit rises in the room as your counselors start to talk. Some hesitantly, some gesturing wildly. They all have ideas. Then my trusted Etrugul. Are we seeking an... to become immortal? Okay. Wait, what? That's it? Or are we going? Oh, there we go. Finally. A supple touch. As per your orders, your Grand Vizier Erdogan has been corresponding with all the important scholarly nobles of the known world. Some of them have been intrigued by the inquiries put forward. Others have been skeptical, while some have been outright dismissive. However, a selected few have been relaying mysterious rumors from the north. Stories surrounding nothing short of magic. Sounding nothing short of magic. Erdogan informs you that one contact in particular is worried about the repercussions if it became known that they have been entertaining these borderline heretic ideas. It pains me to say, my lord, but this sort of gossip does not come for free. He says, brows furrowed. I may be a diplomat, but I'm not a hypnotist. You can't quit now. Make sure this gift reaches your contact. Yes. We have to become immortal. There can only be one. us. Please don't leave the armies there. Everybody is feuding with us and each other. So everybody is not feuding with us, but our pentagram is not really. Working out. What here? Soonest in our family. Mystic appears. Your Grand Vizier Ertugrul is beaming. You know how Takur Chaidiat can be. I had to make sure that it was his son who mentioned it first, and then it was easy to make it seem his idea in the first place. And well, I won't bore you with all the details, he says. Clearly excited to have something noteworthy to tell you. When you roll your eyes for the third time, he finally pulls it together and skips to the part about the mystic woman allegedly traveling the whole world. Strange wonders following her footsteps. Oh, master, I think you shall invite her here. Well, let's invite her. An intriguing encounter. You expected a wrinkled old crone, but the alleged mystic standing before you is something entirely different. Although she is very different compared to all the other women at court, no one can deny that her beauty is breathtaking. With a voice as soft as lamb's wool and tinged with a foreign accent, she introduces herself as Idun, Iodun, Ion. You invite her to dine with you, and her conversation is most intriguing, if not outright controversial at times. She claims to hold the secrets to eternal life and vitality, and offers to teach you more if you are willing to accept her quest. Oh, God. Of course. While it is impossible to know if this fair maiden speaks the truth, at least she seems very experienced for her tender age. But is she immortal? She's just in celibate. Well, I will accept your teachings, Yon. Eternal life must be mine. Of course. I'll be one of the prince of the universe with our okay, we can be allies with you. A serious concern. Erdan joins you after supper one evening. He initiates a conversation about the status of trade in the realm, but you notice that he seems distraught. You interrupt Erdan and demand to know why he has sought you out. My dearest half-brother, I fear for your life, he says earnestly and seizes your hand. Who is this sacrilegious heathen you have invited to your court? Her promises are sweet, I am certain, but she cannot be trusted. Please, half-brother, allow me to find out her true motive before it's too late. But we are trusting. He's our heir. Nonsense, I'm sure you are overreacting. What can happen? Fellowship of the Glade. Ion tells you a tale about a hidden glade in which an ancient apple tree grows. The apples are the most delicious in the world, but more importantly, anyone who eats them becomes young anew. She offers to help you find the glade, but she also warns you that the search will not be easy and potentially very dangerous. Yodun urges you to form a fellowship of brave warriors to aid you in your quest. While you could just order some of your soldiers to tag along, she insists that they must follow you out of loyalty, not only by duty. She suggests that you arrange a grand feast and speak to them for your heart. Spare no expense. Shall form the Fellowship of the Ring. I mean the Glade. The apples. An awkward meeting. It is the night of your feast, yet quiet. Quite few of those invited are missing. You grumble that you ought to have just ordered them to attend. Ion shootingly pets your arm and assures you that you can still turn things around. Halfway through the dinner, you stand up to hold your speech. So far, the right night has been a failure, and this fact does not exactly boost your confidence. Your listeners must notice this, because soon their gazes start to drift, and they fidget uncomfortably in their seats. In the end, you cannot stand it. You cut your speech short and bitterly order all your guests to leave. Ion gives you one last disappointed look before leaving with the rest of them. Oh no, we fail. so close. Binding life immortal. And fussy and timid. There goes our warhorse. He could have become immortal too. But no. We're denied immortality. Our nephew is the heir to the throne. Genius. Oh, this is a girl we are keeping. Our daughter, of course. Good, good. And she had a twin brother. We will come. wasn't the genius one. No, she wasn't. Oh, did Erdogan die? Arrow. Can we? Can we still build? They have built that, okay. Goody goody. Trade post so we get more taxes. Blood oath with these guys. Oh, yep, good. Die, one of them die, finally died in the prison. Good, good. Some education. Ordination of Ethel. Let's do that. Good. And the defensive pact has been dismantled. Good. Because we attacked Byzantine Empire, is that it? I see, these guys are going that way. Well, that's Madrid. Nadirid. I still read it as Madrid. I'm pretty sure at some point we are going to see some peace and down. There we go. There's their army. Have any more? Ooh, there's another army. We intercept them before these guys arrive. Physician. Who's that? Our grandson. Finish the fight, before the reinforcement gets here. Cross the river. Show them the taste that they will soon be getting. We get the grand prize of Constantinople. Exile the demon men. Oh, we could, you know, go and sack Constantinople right away. Oh, but that would mean that we have to... as looters, right? Constantinople. Oh, we should, you know, let's try and make as weak as we can. Effects. I mean, Byzantine Empire will fall. Eventually. Set our course. Oh, hello. Oh, we could win the war already, but I don't want to visit Constantinople first. To tell them that we are coming. Hear us. Thank you. patience. She's the genius one, no. Not touching her. Playful, haughty. Touching her. Goes the castle. Rise of decadence. The ruling dynasty of Muhallabid Sultanate has been overthrown by the zealous and hard living tribesmen of the Batna dynasty. Former vassals may seize this opportunity to declare independence. I see. Wait, it was some mehul sauce. Okay. Oh, rather than threat levels has risen again. Oh, what? Where did our prestige go? Here we go. Wait, what? You dare to oppose us? They're on me. Oh god, really? Just didn't mean to do that. Was easy. They are going to get something from there, Ethiel. And for these guys, we Turei. prestige as soon as we can. Enforce peace again. Okay. I will find a better girl for her, a man for her. Once the time comes. Finally, the final one can be revoked. There we go. Apparently, everyone is content. Okay, that's good. Spymasters. Gone missing. Reports have reached that traders and travelers are being harassed by raiders in our lands. And excellent work. Okay, we are over our limit. research trade practices, it seems. Yes, that was fun. Maybe. Okay. Ah, good. That feud has been settled. Threat levels. Are going down. What spells do we have? But we have non-acres packed with them. Okay. Well, of course. Yeah, we could clean up the booties and the mountains. Has fallen apart. Harlings are still ruling there. Who's ruling Poland? Borkovic. Still the son of Ragnar is still there. Crimea would need to be held. Need to at least 3. Oh. yeah, so you have to have that. What? Did what? Again, where is that kind of thing? Have to build up. Oh, she's a lunatic. Oh, God. A young start for her. Maybe doesn't need to be young. Has to accept this. So all of our family members are adult now. Oh. Well, at least you know all of the closest, all the closest family members. There's no Sunni defensive pact against. That's the Pagan defensive pact. And Taman defensive pact. Wait. Basin of. But, oh, we could invade them. We invade them. Basin of Persia. Nearby Shia rulers. That's Sunni, right? But yes, this shall be all for tonight. It's been a long stream. We have made a nice success after some troubles in the beginning from a lowly Khan. We have become almost the greatest Khan of them all. We still have something to do. No cleaning up this area here. And then deciding where we reign terror next. Dave again. But yes, thanks for watching, and thanks for all the new viewers, new followers, new people in the chat. Always good to see you. New people coming, and well, I hope to see you next time, which will be, of course, tomorrow, or today, for those who are already living the 7th. But yes, thank you for watching, and good night.